she passes, each one she passes goes.
All right. Huh? The Girl from Ipanema. That's Frank Sinatra and me singing The Girl from Ipanema. How y'all doing out there? That's right. That's it, man. Great Latino song. Converted to, well, converted, translated to English. Translates well, I think. All right, let's just get after it, everybody, because you're not here to watch an old man make a fool of himself. Today, we are going to, but I had fun, and I hope you did too, okay? Alrighty, and me having fun is what it's all about, by the way. Okay, today, we're going to take a look at some unusual verbs that we have here, unusual verb forms in Espanol. Let me take that off. Okay, here's the deal. In Spanish, we've got some verbs that don't follow the regular rules in the present, okay? Now, what we're going to do, let's start over here. Okay, we have some verbs, I like to call them, they call them stem verbs. Eh, that's no good. Okay, boo-bye. Dang. Okay, how about this? We're off to a rough start here today, guys. Okay, they have some verbs called stem verbs. Okay? A stem verb is a verb that just does something funky in the conjugation. And we're going to explain what that is, all right? Now, stem verbs, I like to call them shoe verbs. And I'm going to show you why. When we conjugate a regular verb in Spanish, okay, we do it this way. Let me write real big here. We'll give you the big picture. The big picture, okay? I, you, he, she, you formal. Over here we've got we. We've got we, all girls, nosotras, okay? We've got y'all, ustedes, and we've got they. And they, no men allowed, ellas, all females. Okay, do I have a different color? Thank you very much. Now, with a regular verb would conjugate something like this. All right, let's take the verb, to live, vivir. Okay, that means to live. Now, this is a regular verb. It doesn't do anything weird. All right, it is an IR verb, so we're going to take the IR off. And as you know from just looking at the conjugation grid, we're going to take that IR off and we're going to add IR endings. So they all start with something like this. V-I-V, V-I-V, V-I-V. See, because we just took the IR off. So we've got an ending, an ending, an ending. And these are just all on your regular grid. Over here, V-I-V, and these three all just take the same form. So we have V, I, V, and the ending, okay? Now, with this, the thing that makes this a regular verb, doesn't do anything unusual, is you just add the ending right on there. So your IR endings are O, S, A, emos, and N, all right? Therefore, I live, yo vivo, totally regular. You live, tú vives. He or she, él, ella, vive. We live, nosotros vivimos. Y'all live, ustedes viven, or they live, ellas, ellos viven. So there's really only five forms, and that's the way it is really for all your conjugations, even these stem verbs, these shoe verbs. Now, let me show you how it works with a shoe verb, a stem verb, okay? They call it a stem changer. Language geeks love those terminologies, that terminology, right? Okay, but what we've got, looking at my time, all right, can't go over 15 minutes or YouTube will shut me out. All right, now let's take a verb that is not a regular verb. Let's take a verb that is an irregular verb. Now, not vivir. Let's go with the verb. Let's go with the verb, the verb is, let's say, to understand, all right? The verb is entender, which is one way to say understand, entender. Now, this is how you know it's a stem verb, a shoe verb, because it's going to have some little indicator that inside the shoe, it does some funky thing, okay? Some funky, crazy thing. Stop doing that thing. Well, no, it's already established. So, what it is if this were a totally regular verb, watch what it would do. All right, it would be yo entiendo. Tú entiendes. Él, ella entiende. Nosotros entendemos. Ustedes, ellos, ellas entienden. If it were, that's the hypothetical subjunctive verb tense. For you true language snobs out there, you impressed? You ought to be. Anyway, okay, so if it were regular, this is what it would do. Hey, that's easy. You just take off the ER and you just do that same thing. Ha-ha! Ha-ha! I say, ha-ha! It's not that easy. Oh, no. Because this one is a shoe verb, and I'm going to show you why. It's a shoe verb because inside the shoe, what is the shoe that he's always talking about? We don't even know. Watch this. Here's your shoe. Okay? That looks like a shoe, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Okay? All right. Now, this is the shoe. And we do that because inside the shoe, it makes a change that makes it funky. Okay? So check it out. The change that this one makes, and there are many different kinds of shoe changes, of stem changes. This one happens to be, it makes an E to an IE stem change. And it does it with that E, okay? Aha! Well, how does that work? Well, the only thing that means is inside the shoe, it's not just E. It is not just the E, okay? Inside the shoe only, all right? So what it's going to do is inside the shoe, it makes a change. It goes from E to IE. So you're not going to say, oh, yo entiendo. All right, you're going to say yo entiendo. Now it's IE. That's the change it makes. Over here, tú entiendes. It's tú entiendes. El, ella, usted, not entiende, but entiende. Over here, entienden. So when we say it makes a change inside the shoe, it means it does that for all of them, but not the nosotros or the nosotras. That's always outside. Okay, it's not inside the shoe, it's outside the shoe. Okay, now, we have outside the shoe the we. We just leave that alone. Just leave it alone, okay? So we have entendemos. We don't say entiendemos. That would not sound cool, okay? I say okay a lot, don't I? I got to break myself for that, okay? If I'm ever going to make it to the big time. So this is essentially what a shoe verb is. Let's illustrate. Do we have time? Yep. Let's illustrate very quickly with another verb that is also a stem-changing verb, but it is not the same kind of change. In other words, the one we're going to do now, next, is not an E to an IE. All right? Let's do this one. This next verb we're going to do is to cost. Whoops. There we are. Okay. To cost. C-O-S-T-A-R, costar, badly written, okay? Costar, to cost. How much does it cost? So it costs $20. All right, this change is one that goes from O to U-E, all right? O to U-E, and that's the O. Now, that happens inside the shoe, so watch what we've got, all right? We've got, let's do it if it were regular. It would be costo, costas, costa, running out of time, costamos, costa. All right, if it were regular, that's what it would be, but it's not regular, all right? It is irregular. All right, so this is what we've got. Now, you know what we're going to do, don't you? Inside the shoe, the O makes a change. The O becomes U-E. So let's do that. We're taking the O out, all right? And we're going to use U-E. Now, you don't have to do this step where you go, let's write the O and then erase it and put in UE. That's just to illustrate to you, to show you kind of how that works, okay? All right, now, all right, that's just as bad. Instead of yo costo, it's going to be yo cuesto. Tú cuestas. Él, ella, cuesta. Nosotros costamos. That's outside. We leave it outside. It sounds better. Nosotros costamos. All right? But then back inside the shoe, it's not costan, it is cuestan. Cuesta. Oh, my bad. Did somebody catch that earlier? Mm-hmm. There we go. Cuestan. And your endings for AR verbs, o, as, a, amos, and an. This is essentially a shoe verb. Now, there's different kinds of changes. Do I have time? I got time for one more, all right? Let's do one more verb that works very... It's a different kind of stem change, okay? The verb to serve. The verb to serve. And that is... servir, to serve. Like, they're serving dinner at 7 o'clock, whatever it is. In this case, the stem change is an E... to an I in the shoe verb, okay? So instead of saying yo servo, I'm going to say yo sirvo. You serve to sirves. El, ella, usted sirve. Now, outside the shoe, the we, all right, the we, we've got we... There we go. Okay. Yeah, but Fino, what about the IE? You already know the answer to that question. It's outside the shoe. You never change it outside the shoe. You just leave it alone. Okay? So we have servimos, and then once again down here back in the shoe, y'all or they, we go back to an I because the E changes to the I in the shoe. Very good. That is essentially what stem changing verbs, I call them shoe verbs. Sometimes you call them boot verbs. That is essentially what they are. All right? So let's leave it right there. I don't think I have time to sing you another song, but thanks for coming today, okay? Tall and tan and young and lovely, the girls from Ipanema goes walking, and when she passes, each one she passes goes... Oh, sorry. Ah. Me and Frank, we got it. See y'all later. Ciao. Adios.